Good evening. Thanks so much for joining us tonight. Take a look at what was billowing out of Halemaumau Crater today, one of the biggest ash plumes over the past week. Now, this isn't the big steam explosion they're expecting, but man, what a sight to see. And all that ash is causing some health concerns. My co-anchor Howard Deshefsky has more now from the Big Island. Hi, Howard.
Marissa, I got to tell you, it was an amazing sight that we witnessed this morning. And no, you're correct. It's not, quote unquote, the big one. Of course, over the past several days, most of the attention has been focusing around the lower East Rift Zone, where all the fissures have been breaking out. Those have been very dramatic. But today, a lot of the attention turned to the summit up at Halemaumau, where we saw the biggest ash explosion to date. In fact, at its height, we're told the plume reached more than 12,000 feet in the air. And that was enough for issues to be warned not only to nearby surrounding residents, but even to aviators. For Susan Cabral and her husband Randy, the morning started in dramatic fashion. The awe of this force of nature and what you've witnessed, and as you look at this,
it's unbelievable. It's spectacular and it's frightening at the same time. We don't know where we're going to go, what we're going to do. Depends on which way the wind blows.
From her home in Volcano Village, about 3 miles away from the Halemaumau Crater, they watched in amazement as Mother Nature was on full display.
This is Madame Pele's country, and we're her guests.
According to scientists at the U.S. Geological Survey, this was all part of the ongoing activity at Halemaumau, and the potential for a powerful explosion caused by receding lava interacting with cooler underground water still exists.
It intensified today, but it wasn't the big one, so to speak. Does that mean that we won't see a much bigger, more explosive event? No, not necessarily. It could plug up, and we could yet in the future have the so-called big one. Today was more of a gradual ramp up, and it was continuous enough that we felt it was significant to put out a public warning.
A half hour or so down Highway 11 in the town of Pahala, residents we spoke with tell us the ash has been raining down all morning. Deborah, this volcano's been going a while, but the past 24 hours, and especially this morning, big difference?
Pretty big. Air quality, definitely. A lot more ash. Breathing-wise, more than anything else.
Deborah says she's seen many ash falls over the years, but living downwind of this volcano now is much different.
I have anxiety about it, definitely. You know, born and raised here, so it's definitely a lot more scary. You see the plumes come in, you think ash is going to be covered all over the place. So, you know, trying to get things covered as much as possible, we're prepared as much as possible, you know, with masks and things like that.
Deborah says the ashfall here in Pahala has been significant over the past 24 hours, but the majority of it, she says, has come down just today. Back up in Volcano, the winds are blowing in Susan's favor. If the winds were to change, talk about your concerns between your water catchment, your animals.
Okay, well, we've already taken some precautions to detach our gutters from the downspouts to reduce the amount of ash getting into our water tanks. The animals, if we can just keep giving them fresh water, I don't know how it's going to affect the pasture. If we get a good rain, it's not so much of a concern, but if the ash is on the grass that they feed on, we don't have a barn big enough to shelter all of our animals.
Although Hawaii Volcanoes National Park remains closed indefinitely, the view from outside the park was nothing short of spectacular. And for both visitors to the islands and locals alike, they all stood there, mesmerized, watching in total awe. It truly was a sight to see, and again, a lot of folks just saw on Highway 11 there. One quick warning, we're told from the Hawaii Volcanoes National Park, they don't want people lining up on Highway 11 because it can be very dangerous. Now, we can also tell you that this matter that comes out, this ashfall, it's a particulate. There's nothing in terms of harmful chemicals actually in it. But again, officials say the best thing to do is avoid it. If at all possible, stay indoors, turn on your air conditioner, and don't breathe these ashes if you see them raining down on your home. That's the best advice, Marissa. We're going to send it back to you.